It's the second time in about a week that these protesters will be coming out in demonstration of their disapproval with the increment of their school fees. They are students of the University of Lagos who are asking for a downward review of the hike. It's a rainy day, but the downpour doesn't seem strong enough to stop them.
It's a walk in the rain for the protesters who defy the downpour to register their grievances.
Because they cannot fund anything.
As they march, they chant the reason for the protest. They are not alone. Men of the Nigeria Police, the DSS, NSCDC and the University Security Unit join them to ensure there's no breakdown of law and order. The students, who are joined by colleagues from other universities, say the hike in their fees did not have a human face.
A country where minimum wage is 30,000 has no business with hiking fees to 215,000, has no business with hiking fees of accommodation to 140,000, and has no business in hiking fees of faculty to 35,000 naira. So the cost of transportation is there, cost of feeding, projects, research, and everything. So to come to the University of Lagos now, you'll be budgeting at least 1 million naira in 3 months. That is in the poverty capital of the world.
The school authorities insist they are in touch with their leaders.
Let me establish that most of the people you see out there are not our students. I can tell you that, I mean, confidently, because we are engaging with our students. I still met with student leaders yesterday. So they are the one that can represent other students.
This protest, we Nigerian students and University of Lagos students in particular are about to break world record of holding the longest hours of protest, and it's going to happen.
The students are raising concerns that many of them will drop out of school should the new rate persist.
No UNILAG student will drop out if they come to us. They won't, because we've taken care of that. That's why we talked about the indigent package. None of them will drop out. If they see the DSA, they'll be taken care of. We recognize that we have indigent students. We've always had.
While the school management is accusing the protesters of being inconsiderate, judging by the economic realities in the country, the students, on the other hand, insist the hike is too high for a single increment. Hopefully, both parties will reach a compromise before school resumes for a new academic session in October. Timothy Crown, Adiribibe, Channels Television News.